Got around the corner, almost.
Make a motion, we accept the minutes of the.
Flipping all the switches, so these guys.
March 22nd.
They were all in my favor.
Okay, budget of the truck plow.
I think the one always.
Put that one. Sorry. And then last minute budget adjustment. Kind of got thrown off guard.
I have to fess up. Get the weight out.
Running around. Make copies at the last second, so. All right, you guys approve the minutes, right?
Yep.
All right, budget updates. So, are you ready?
Oh, sure.
I'll save these two.
Yeah, you can.
Perfect time.
Because we're having a discussion on.
What is the perfect timing?
Some of the new stuff? New budgets.
You guys probably want to do inserts first before we get into them, so that things you're looking at match.
Pick the ones that are wide open.
While you're. Once you guys get those, then I'll just give you a real quick update on what the changes were for those inserts.
Thank you.
Last week, huh?
The whole week?
That's a good business.
I love those people.
Oh, yeah.
They drive us. Drive it all. Mind if I get started?
Yep. Go.
Okay, so I passed out a bunch of updates to you guys, and I just wanted to give you a quick rundown on what those updates were. Highway department budget was updated. I added $500 to that budget to cover a shared bucket truck, which we passed. Sorry, I've been writing.
Mark, before you jump in, the 5153.
59.
Okay, let's just do the updates. Then we'll do the discussion of the 51. I would like to go through each department one by one.
Okay.
While we're together.
Okay.
And just to see if we're all on the same page with that. So we can do them both at the same time, or we can run through the updates now and come back.
It's your call.
Why don't we do it that way? That way you can highlight the update on that particular.
As it comes up?
Yeah.
Okay.
You guys good with that? Because we really haven't done this as a.
We need capital as well, because there are.
Yeah. Capital is where we start. We're just taking an order as it is in the as it is in the book. Okay.
So the update to the capital worksheet that I just passed out, Chief Hannum has reduced his request for capital from $47,000 to $18,000.
Six. Everybody on six?
Yep.
I'm going to pass around his quote for the emissions exhaust system at the fire department. So the capital sheet's been updated, and the budget has been updated to reflect that as well.
So right now it's 18?
Yep, it's just shy of 18, I just rounded it.
What's 43 or something?
It was 47.
47?
47 and change.
Went from 47 to 18?
Yeah.
47 to 18.
What are we missing?
I don't know if it's a different, not here, is it?
I'll speak for it a little bit. I don't know what they got a quote from before, but I've looked into these very recently. And the difference really is, it's instead of you having these units that are really hooked up to the trucks and everything, you know, these are a very specialized unit that sits, they have charcoal filters and everything, so instead of exhausting everything, they take and they filter everything through that. And we had looked at it for a lot of different reasons, but one, it was so easy. You put one, they come in, they size you up for the number of days you have, and this and that, and the installation and all that. So it's a lot cleaner system, it's a lot easier system, the installs are easy.
And it's less expensive.
It's less, you know, they're not cheap, but based on, you know, everything else that you have to go along with it, especially for what our our station is, you know, I think it's a good move.
Okay.
And they are, there's quite a few of them, I said quite a few of them, there's at least two or three in the area with a high rate of success.
Okay, great.
So you have the quotes and the information from the company.
We do, that's good. Yeah. So for FY17, what we are essentially recommending is that we're replacing the dump truck $145,000. We're paving the highway lot to the salt shed for $13,000. The exhaust emissions is now 18. Generator elementary school has been deferred to next year. Paving building repairs, $10K. What was that?
Police.
Police.
That's right.
Then we got the, we also approved a police cruiser for $35,000, replacing the '09. And then on the library, we have a, we heard about that, the entrance and the roof, et cetera, at $15,500. Maintenance shed, going down the rec commission, maintenance shed for the blue school, $3,000. Whately Elementary School gym padding, $6,000. So we got a total on the capital of $245,500.
There's a new water department capital below that.
Right, and now we're going on to the water, but that is the enterprise fund, so that does have some payback in. So the generator for pump house on the water enterprise is $10,000. Truck replacement, $5,000.
What kind of truck they gonna get for $5,000?
Five a year for 7 years.
What's that?
Five a year for 7 years, I was putting in there, Bob.
Okay.
So we have it.
Gotcha. Oh yeah, I see it in back and I see it going forward. Okay. And clean the waterproof tank, $15,000. So it's, that's an every other year thing?
No, that's one, that's the first time the outside has been cleaned and sealed since it was built in 1987. It gets inspected every 5 years, and the last time the company did the inspection, the inside is fine, but you get the exterior surface begins to crack, and then when it starts to separate, the water gets in the cracks, and then you get bad things starting to happen. So it needs to be cleaned and then sealed again on the outside.
Did we not do it in FY15?
It's about 30, so we took it in 15 and 15.
Okay.
How long is the tank supposed to last?
That's a concrete tank, Bobby. If you seal it, take care of it, it should, I think that thing will last forever. That's, you know, it's not a steel tank, it's not gonna rust. As long as you keep the outside sealed once every 20 years or so, I can't imagine anything would go wrong with it unless something hits it.
All right, thanks, Bob. Any other questions?
I have a question about the filters down the fire department, Joe.
Yep.
How long? I don't know how much per year is going to
No, it's a good point. That's I don't think is in this budget. That would be how often. That would be an operational cost. It's going to depend on how many runs they're making and all of that. So I can't answer. They're not cheap. It's a four filter system, but I'm sure it's not in this operating budget.
It probably will be next year. The maintenance and replacement. Or will it be $14,000?
No.
Okay.
Anything else before we leave?
We did not vote last time on the exhaust emission system. We voted on everything else on the capital. We did not vote on the table.
That's true. Do we have a motion?
I make a motion. We authorize $18,000 for the exhaust emission system for the fire department.
Second.
All those in favor?
Aye.
Aye. Unanimous. All right, let's go to the page 23, the planning board. Their request is $1,982. Please note, Mark, they are not, they don't have any expenses.
I actually received an email from Mary for the ZBA and the planning board, but I literally just got it 10 minutes
ago. Okay, you got it? Okay, fine.
So I do have those figures, I just haven't had a chance to open them and tally them yet.
Alrighty. So, planning board, any issues, any thoughts, any questions?
Okay. You want to approve them one at a time, or are we just going to go?
Probably should approve them one at a time.
I make a motion we approve the zoning. Or the planning board budget.
Second.
All those in favor?
Aye.
Aye. Passed. Okay. Select board.
No, ZBA.
Oh, okay.
What are you doing there? 24.
What page are you on?
24, ZBA.
Yeah, you want to go back to the select board on 11 and start there?
Yeah, we're going, how did we get to the planning board then?
Because if you're just following it, I'm by the numerical pages.
Planning board's 23 though.
Yeah.
You were on 23, you should be at 24.
Okay.
All right. Select board.
What is it?
So 11?
Yep.
Page 11?
Yep. Okay, select board. $99,378. An increase. $10,000. Do we know what that increase is?
Well, there's an audit in there for $3,000 that wasn't in there last year.
If you want to know the total percentage increase, it should be back on page 3. It's 10.6%.
I make a motion, we accept the select board budget.
All those in favor?
Aye.
So now if we go on to the next page, we page 12.
Yep, legal.
Okay?
Yep.
All right.
Make a motion, we accept the legal.
I'll second.
All those in favor?
Aye.
And make note that they had what they expended. Town report?
Same thing. Make a motion, we accept the town report budget.
Second.
All those in favor?
Aye.
14, town buildings. Town buildings request $62,040, up from $26,890 appropriated, up from $21,850 expended. I think we're probably sitting in the increase right now.
You're sitting in the increase right now.
Okay.
Sandy Lane.
Any issues?
I make a motion, we accept the budget, town building budget.
All those in favor?
Aye.
Okay.
Town clerk?
Something like. Some reason, I don't have 16. Let's just look. Town clerk. Okay, 31486. Up $3,000. Any issues with any of the increases? Elections are up $3,500, I think Lynn explained that pretty well.
We got an extra election.
So.
Make a motion, we accept the town clerk budget.
Second.
All those in favor?
Aye.
Page 17. Town accountant. We're up to $19,500, up from $16,200.
That's due to increased salaries?
Increased salary, Mark?
It's an increased assessment. If you.
But it's due to increased hours, isn't it, that assessment?
Yeah, it is. He's been, if you look at page 19, we were budgeted for 6 hours, and he's been here about 9.39 hours, if you total up last year. So FERCog has asked that we adjust it by 1 hour, and we'll reevaluate next year.
Motion?
Make a motion, we accept the town accountant budget.
Second.
All those in favor?
Aye.
Okay. Treasurer collector, page 21. Requested $54,966, up about $3,000 from 16, up 12, almost $13,000 from expenses from FY15.
How are we due to the assistant?
The assistant treasurer.
Yep. Okay, I think we beat that one. I make a motion we accept the treasurer collector's budget.
Second.
All those in favor?
Aye.
Okay. Assessors, page 22, we're at 37,138. We're up 5 in appropriation, we're up almost 7 from expenses in FY 15.
Reval.
Reval numbers. Yep. I make a motion we accept the assessor's budget. Okay.
Second.
All those in favor?
Aye.
Go. 23.
24, zoning.
24, zoning board of appeals, 22,5. He's up a grand, close. What's that?
Clerical.
Salaries.
Yeah, we need an adjustment to the salaries to reflect the actual hours that she's working. And there was also a salary adjustment for that position, so it's a combination of both.
All right.
I make a motion we accept the ZBA budget.
Second.
All those in favor?
Aye.
Okay.
I make a motion we accept the conservation commission budget.
Second. Make no expenses on conservation commission. Mark, have you received anything for that group?
No, not yet. I believe they're still working on it.
We had a motion, we had a second. All of those in favor?
Aye.
Okay.
Historical commission.
Historical commission.
Make a motion we accept the budget.
Second.
All those in favor?
Aye.
What do they spend $200 on?
They haven't.
Is that the end of the year party?
The block party.
The block party, that's what it is. Okay, agricultural commission, page 27, $1,500. Brochure printing, $1,300.
Nothing for 17.
I don't think they spent any money in 15.
Okay.
I think that was something, that was a project they were planning to do and haven't done it yet, so.
I think they paid for it through donations, which they got a lot more donations than they were expecting. So they paid for it with the donations.
I don't see any requests for 17, fiscal year 17, on my copy at least.
Oh, I'm sorry, it was leveled. I don't think I expected that. I need to extend that column. I'll make that adjustment on there.
But just so we're understanding here, we appropriated $1,300 for the brochure printing in FY 14, which means they wanted to do it in FY 13. We see no expenses for 14. We see no appropriation for 15.
Well, there's a total.
There's a total, but there's, you know, there's no line item. There's no.
That money's just rolled to free cash the past couple of years, so.
They haven't spent it, so.
You know where I'm getting to on this, right?
They're not using it?
They're not using it, you know, they're not using it. I mean, it'd be great if they did, but they're not. Okay, do we have a motion on this?
I make a motion we accept the agricultural commission budget of $1,500 for FY 17.
Second.
All those in favor?
Aye.
Housing committee, $200.
Motion to accept?
I make a motion we accept the housing committee budget.
Second.
All those in favor?
Aye.
Triton Beach.
Triton Beach.
No expenses.
No expenses, level fund.
I did not receive a request from them. They're actually meeting in the other room right now. I leveled it in the budget this year.
That's all they're getting, then?
And I don't think they're using that much, so I think it's probably fine to level it.
But this is a piece of that pie, right? This is our share of it.
Yes.
Yeah.
You're right. So do we get an overview of everything?
I've requested it, and my understanding is that they're discussing it tonight. They were included in that email that I copied you on requesting expenditures and details.
Okay.
I make a motion we level fund the Tri-Town Beach budget, $44,39.35.
Second.
All in favor?
Aye.
Recreation.
Recreation Commission, $12,125, they came in, I think we had a discussion on that.
I make a motion, we accept the recreation budget.
Second.
All those in favor?
Aye.
Then we have Cemetery Commission.
I make a motion, we accept the cemetery budget.
Second.
All those in favor?
Aye.
Okay, we have Library at $64,296. We got about a 10K increase there. She did a great job in putting together, you know, what she does, why she needs the extra money.
Justify that.
Do we have any issues? Any?
Chimney and gutters.
I make a motion, we accept the library budget.
Second.
All those in favor?
Aye.
Does anybody here go to the library?
I have, yes. Not all the time, but I do go.
One question on this, on the library here.
Yep.
The wrap and roof repairs.
Yep.
Increased from $950 to $2,000. That went back to the capital, right?
Did that come out of capital?
Should that be in this?
I thought I asked him about that. I don't remember what the response is.
I think so. I think it's just maybe with repairs.
No, that was just repairs because of that strange gutter system.
Yeah, the big, the capital expense is for the, like, the gutters that are
integrated
inside the edge of the roof.
Nothing to do with a ramp.
It wasn't gonna be capital, I don't think.
Yeah, they mentioned replacing the ramp.
Yeah, the ramp was included.
In capital.
But I think it went up because of the integrated gutter system.
I think so.
Be repaired.
So they took that out, the ramp?
No, I think they gotta do, they have to do something with the ramp. There's no handrail on it, right?
I just wonder why it's included in both.
I think that is their general maintenance line, right? They're not just specific to ramp and roof repairs.
Maintenance, yeah.
All righty.
Senior Center?
Did we vote on the library?
Yeah.
All righty. Where are we here?
Senior Center.
What page are you?
33.
33.
Yeah, there you go.
Okay. What is one?
Yeah.
$15,700.
Why is it in
$401?
Italics or whatever the hell you call it.
So we got a total here of $15,701.
Yep. Up from 13,910.
Up a couple grand.
Yeah.
And
most of that is director salary and assistants. I make a motion, we accept the senior center budget.
Second. All those in favor?
Aye.
So what's gonna happen there?
You're eventually gonna go there.
What do you think they're gonna do there?
Not sure yet.
Oh, no, yeah.
There's a new director who has
I know, it's a dummy, they're probably condemned. You know, I would say they're condemned in a year and a half or so. Yeah, it's a dummy.
Well, we might have some space here.
That's why I'm just wondering where they're headed with what's going on there.
Based on what that ambulance wants to do. We'll find out tomorrow night, right? Okay.
Veterans budget.
Veterans budget, $78.15, down from $89.90. That's an unusual one.
I make a motion, we accept the veterans budget.
Oh, God, was it?
Second.
All those in favor?
Aye.
Okay. All right.
Who is the veteran's agent?
Who's what?
Who is the veteran's agent? Is it Kennedy?
Mark Dunwoo, I haven't seen that one. I don't know.
You know who it is, Lynn?
It's a central
Oh, we don't have our own?
Central something, Pioneer Valley Veterans, and I can't remember the one that serves in Whately.
Okay, we have the local council on aging, $500 request. Community outreach.
I make a motion, we accept that.
Second.
All those in favor?
Aye.
Page 37.
Second. Board of Health.
Board of Health, $25,23. pretty much flat line.
Yeah, they make them, they dropped $100 for office supplies.
That's pretty centralized.
Yeah, office supplies are a combined account.
I make a motion, we accept the Board of Health budget.
All in favor?
Aye.
And there we have the solid waste.
Solid waste.
Solid waste.
Or this is the agent.
Foothills.
Foothills Health.
That's part of the.
Yeah, that's part of.
Oh, okay.
Okay, solid waste, 39. Pretty much explains it on the next page. Waste, recycling. Fiscal year 16, what they're looking for in 17. Good report.
I make a motion, we accept the solid waste budget.
Second.
All in favor?
Aye.
43.
Page 43. Fire department. They would like $61,090 fiscal 17.
I have a question.
Question.
The uniforms, AFF grant match, is this, oh, this is the match, this isn't the grant, this isn't what it's gonna be.
No, that's our, I asked John to include that $3,150 in his operating budget, because if we do get the grant, that's our match.
Did John give himself a raise?
No.
No.
It's just a call.
Oh, it's cool. John here?
I make a motion, we accept the fire department.
Second.
All in favor?
Aye.
Okay, we have the police budget, 45,181,832, up $5,000. I think we had a very in-depth explanation of this by Chief Sabine, who was here. Any questions, any?
I make a motion, we accept the police department budget.
Second.
All in favor?
Aye.
You want to do animal control and animal inspector together?
Yeah, it's the same department. I make a motion, we accept animal control and animal inspector budget.
Second.
All in favor?
Aye.
Okay.
Emergency management went up $10. I make a motion, we accept the emergency management budget.
Second.
All in favor?
Aye.
Highway department budget on page 51 and actually 53. With it.
51, 52, and 53.
Right, so these budgets, 361,791. Keep yourself a look, he's up a little bit, but.
I just gave you an updated sheet, and the only amendment was the $500 line for the shared bucket truck.
Any final questions on this as you look at it?
Keith is here.
Okay, just in case, Keith, see if you have any questions.
What's the status of the bucket truck? We approved the money last year.
Finally, the agreement is on the selectmen's agenda tonight to be signed. Big delays in legal counsel between the different towns on trying to negotiate. The language was very frustrating.
Hydraulic hose or whatever, who's paying for it?
Right, we've had other contracts, but yet they all want to have a reason why their language is different, and so it took a long time.
What is the truck worth, like $250,000?
No.
What's that?
$15,000.
It's a $7,000 from each town, so we're buying a used truck. We hope to have the truck purchased by the end of fiscal year.
We'll have more in it in legal fees than we got in the truck.
Probably.
All right, I make a motion we accept the highway department.
All those in favor?
Aye.
54, water department.
You want to do 54 and 55?
Yeah, 55 together. Total of 73.50. Up the chunk.
Backup operators.
Manganese issues.
Manganese. Yeah, well, we've heard all about that.
All right, I make a motion we accept the water department budget.
All those in favor?
Aye.
57.
I just gave you a new skims packet. And the update on this is that our assessment went down $25,000 from the last budget draft that we received. So I literally just got this at 20:05 today, so I don't have a great explanation for you other than
we just getting lucky. Like,
what does that mean overall? That's less. That's what.
Somebody's getting more.
Well,
somebody's
no, I think
more.
No, I think they. They're funding the new ambulance out of their capital stabilization fund or something like that instead of assessing it equally among towns. So they made some adjustments during their process in Deerfield, which ended up reducing our assessment. So.
They took in over $500,000 in fees. Transports.
Cost to be paid out of retained earnings. So that's
yeah, here it is.
Retained earnings.
Okay. All right, that's good.
So it's 101.783. Is that what I'm seeing?
Yeah, it's down from 125.
101.783. Have a motion?
I make a motion we accept the scans budget.
Second.
All those in favor?
Aye.
Okay. Right. Finance committee?
I'm not recommending this.
$470.
I make a motion we accept the finance committee budget.
Second.
Is this for the block party?
Yeah, block party.
Is this itemized out so we can see what's.
Oh, we can have called to the T. All those in favor?
Aye.
Yeah, we got the rules.
So, if you want to flip back to page 3, I can touch on some of the other updates to the overall budget, which is pages 3 through 5. So some adjustments were made this week, including, like I said, the SCEMS. Planning board and EMD budgets were updated. I apparently didn't give you the COLA updates last week with all the other COLAs on those, so when I was going through the budget today, I just made some copies of those for you. There's a new table of contents, obviously, to match the updates you received. Smith Vocational, I removed $12,300 from the budget because we had no students apply this year. I wasn't sure until last week whether or not we'd have a student apply, so that's been removed from the budget. However, I did adjust the unemployment insurance from $7,000 to $12,500 based on the fact that the two IAs that will be leaving the elementary school, when they were here last week to explain that.
Yep.
I wanted to increase that line just to offset.
What's the I for? I know aid assistant.
Instructional.
Instructional assistant, right. Okay.
And you'll see that the changes that were made by removing the Smith vocational tuition, slightly adjusting the unemployment insurance, and the reduction in SCEMS and the reduction in the capital expense for the fire department ended up changing the bottom line and the estimated tax rate, which you'll see on page 5B. I believe it was 1549 last week in that. So,
yep.
So those changes had a pretty significant impact.
And what's the number now?
1535. Also on 5B, you'll see that the free cash amount has changed slightly now that the capital requests from the fire department have been reduced. So the new number is $100,500 in capital plus $200,000 in free cash offset.
Which is going to leave us how much in free cash?
You should have around a little over $200,000 left in free cash. After all the capital expenses are paid for, with the exception of dump truck, we'll borrow for that, and after using $200,000 to offset taxation.
You're going to borrow for the dump truck? 3 years.
3 years.
Fire truck is?
5 years. And that's covered in short-term debt here also. The other dump truck that we purchased a few years ago has one more year.
Yeah.
It's in FY17, that payment will roll off next year.
So we're going to dump one and start another.
Yep.
All right. Any other thoughts, questions, concerns?
This is probably our last meeting, right?
Okay, we meet again on the 5th
to
approve next Tuesday to go through the draft warrant and make your recommendations. That draft warrant will include this budget.
I will be out of town.
Yeah, so I will be out of town.
And you'll be out.
What day?
Next Tuesday.
Yeah. Do we have four at least?
Yeah. But during that meeting, I think it would, if we have time to discuss what the calendar would look like for us, not to put any meetings in, anything like that, we have to loosely structure a calendar that is more reflective of what we need to do. Whatever that means at this point, you know. But I just had a feeling that this is kind of what normally happens, but it's far too much
to adjust.
Yeah. Far too much of a rush towards the end. And I understand a lot of that is how the numbers flow and how they
come. Yeah, we don't get it.
This is getting more and more complicated all the time.
Yeah.
It used to be a lot easier. Now it's getting more complicated.
Yeah. So we have to get an idea of what we need to see from a department, okay, before that department number comes in, and I so that we have a better sense of how expenses are going over time.
So I guess I would just say two things on that. Budget requests are due January 1st, and even though you guys don't normally start meeting until February, you could really start meeting in January to look at those. It won't be compiled like this, but you're going to be starting.
You can get a handle on where you're headed.
Yeah,
you'll get a picture, a general idea.
And you just reminded me a quick update on expenditures. Mm-hmm. The town accountant did say that he can do subcategories within budgets.
Really?
If he has, I mean, he can't do, you know, some of these budgets have like 25 different lines on them. He can, they'll have to somewhat summarize that, but he said he'll be able to do that and break it down.
That'll help. So Keith and the police, because the ones that have 35 columns on them are usually done.
They're
usually complete. But it's the ones that have 3, 4, and 5 that there's nothing.
So the plan at this point is, after we get through town meeting, I will ask department heads to give the accountant a list of categories that they want within their budget. They'll create those accounts, and then on July 1st, we'll start. There's no point in tracking them for the balance of the fiscal year, because it's just going to be a portion of a year.
Right.
So beginning July 1st, he'll start tracking those. So when a department head submits a bill, they'll have to submit a bill that says, you know, I want this bill to go in this subcategory, so that at the end of the year, they'll be able to do their expenditures much more easily.
Good.
Unfortunately, it's not going to help us for next budget year, because we're still going to have to do it the old-fashioned way next year, because if we start on the fiscal year, those expenditures won't close out until the following fiscal year, or the following budget year.
But everyone knows now that we're asking for that.
Yes.
Conservation Commission, all those people that have three line items, just look at your receipts and what you just spent, you know. So,
is there a possibility to go one step further and have the year that we don't see any expenses for, which is the fiscal year we're in, do a projection to the end of the fiscal year, so that we have an even more accurate number to? I mean, it'll be a projection, but it'll only be in months.
You lost me on that.
What do you mean a projection?
We're in fiscal year 16,
yep.
But it hasn't completed yet until right. June 30. So when they submit their budgets, if they could project at that point the expenses from when they submit their budgets
so
to the end of the fiscal year.
They'll be about halfway through the fiscal year at that point.
Well, that's better than nothing, yeah. I feel like. That's all. Yeah.
I mean, we can ask and see what happens.
The only thing with the providing a half-year budget is, like with my town clerk budget, my expenses are all in the second half, yeah. Or a lot of times. So it's hard if I give you the first 6 months, it's not going to be half of the budget. It may only be, you know, a third of the budget, but then I'd have to give an explanation. I could give an explanation on what I'm predicting will be the second half. But
there are a lot of other budgets that have monthly expenses that they could actually do a pretty good projection. I think. I don't know. That's
we can look at formatting. That's budget request.
That would be really more helpful.
So I'm clear. You're suggesting 6 months actual and then 6 months projection combined. Give 12
either,
months
either
total
separate,
projection.
Either separate or combined, but at least to have some numbers in that current fiscal year that we're in.
Yeah. Well, I think it's a good start to taking to being able to project.
Absolutely, that helped me a great deal this year to see what expenses we had.
To give you an idea of all this extra paperwork, the town of Conway did an efficiency study and have now given their town boss secretary 5 hours a week so he can do his town boss work.
Highway
boss, yeah. Sorry. Time boss.
Yep.
Town road boss, that's what I meant to say.
Town road boss. You got to watch it, you know, like Ben Franklin says. Watch the pennies. He also said, beer proves that God loves us.
Yes. I've seen that somewhere.
Okay.
Can I ask one more question?
Yep.
I know the budget is our main focus for this committee, but I think there is an end of year audit and financials produced, and that is. Are those financials only produced once a year, or are they done quarterly, or?
Last year we had an audit that covered three fiscal years.
Okay, but our accountant must do financials at least once a year, not audit fiscal year, but just a set of financials. Balance sheet,
income statement,
assets.
End of the fiscal year.
Just once a year? Because it makes it hard for us to look at the financials if it's only once a year. I'm just saying.
That's probably all to require. Yeah.
Actually, in the Finance Committee handbook, the state that Lynn gave me several years ago, it does say at least quarterly.
I think we'd probably be looking at expanding his hours pretty significantly.
You know, that's
Yeah.
That's my guess anyway. I mean, he's already doing well over his 6 hours a week now.
Yeah.
We have started to do some more detailed reconciliation at this point we're concentrating on 6 months between the treasurer collector and the town accountant to make sure that we're jiving rather than waiting until the end of the year and then trying to find where you might be off. So we're tackling it every 6 months now, and our goal is to tackle that quarterly, but that is not the whole balance sheet. It's just the reconciliation, making sure we're on the right track. So,
well, whatever information that could be shared with the finance committee, I think would be helpful to see where we're at. All I'm saying is that's part of our responsibility, and I think it would be. I don't want anybody to be working any overtime or anything. It's hard to. I found this job to be almost harder than my real work job because of the information that is flown through here. And this year was easier because the expenses were there, and I think the process was different. And I really felt this year went a lot smoother than other years, at least for me. I don't know about the rest of the information makes it.
I think if we can get on a schedule,
yep,
that gets us into the game earlier,
yep,
I think it'll even be more conducive to a better understanding.
I agree.
And so I think that'll definitely put that in the schedule for next week.
I made a note, so I'll put it on the agenda.
Okay.
Let's take a vote on this budget so that I can move this to the end. Yeah.
I make a motion we accept the budget as it's presented for FY 17.
Second.
All those in favor?
Aye.
Aye. Yeah, the next time you'll see it will be on the warrant.
Okay. You can still adjust it.
Okay. Motion to adjourn?
Make a motion we adjourn.
All those in favor? See you next week.